It explicitly informs the learner and focuses attention on the sounds and rhythms of the target language. This approach is used to complement, rather than replace, the intuitive imitative approach. The communicative approach originated in the 1980s. It suggests that using language to communicate should be central in all classroom language instruction. Is necessary for communication to take place. How then do we teach pronunciation? Teachers and developers of materials found that an emphasis on rhythm, word stress, sentence stress, and intonation is the best way to organize a short-term pronunciation course for non-native speakers. It is imperative for the instructor to have knowledge of the English sound system and to be familiar with a variety of teaching techniques which uses communicative activities. Learn. Several factors, such as the learner's ages, exposure to the target language, amount and type of prior pronunciation instruction, and their attitude and motivation to achieve intelligible speech patterns all influence how students learn. Native language transfer also plays a role in learning proper pronunciation. However, the goal is not to make learners sound like native speakers, even if that were feasible. The goal instead is to enable learners to communicate and to avoid oral communication problems. What strategies then can teachers use to help students learn correct pronunciation in a communicative way? How can the pronunciation of unintelligible speakers of English become intelligible? Here is a list of some methods that places emphasis on getting the sounds right at the word level. Listen and imitate. In other words, the students would listen to a pre-recorded lesson or listen to their teachers and imitate what they hear. Another method is phonetic training. Minimal pair drills, visual aids, tongue twisters, reading aloud, and recitation focusing on stress, timing, and intonation. Recording learners' production of speeches, conversations, and role plays. It is very helpful then for the student to listen to their own speech patterns. The practice of individual sounds combined with communicative activities provide a balanced way to teach pronunciation. Communicative teaching method has as its main objective the improvement of student communication skills. It's a practical approach to learn and hear how language really sounds in everyday life, and it makes for a more serious and creative teaching atmosphere. Directions in teaching pronunciation. According to Gilbert, 1994, there are three guiding principles that can assist teachers in moving beyond traditional teaching practices. Include the following. Using methods other than mechanical drills or rules. Again, if we go back to how to teach using communication, we understand that mechanical drills or rules really do not help somebody learn how to interact and to express themselves. We also emphasize the musical aspects of pronunciation more than sound. In addition, it makes language learning more interesting for students. Direction that's being followed is teaching real speech patterns and giving students practice and efficient guessing of what discourse signals imply. This is something that would normally come up in conversation when students are not sure exactly what is being said. They will guess at what the meaning would imply. Adapting authentic material taken from the fields of drama, psychology, and speech pathology would include the use of fluency-building activities and accuracy-oriented exercises. This will appeal to visual, auditory, tactile, and kinesthetic modes of learning. Anything can be also taken from television and film. Instructional technology will continue to play an important role in language teaching. It is generally agreed upon that a balance of methods of teaching pronunciation is optimal. Works cited: Marianne Sell Muna, Donna M. Britton, Janet M. Goodwin, Teaching Pronunciation, Cambridge Press, University Press, 2000. Gilbert J. B., Intonation, A Navigation Guide for the Listener. Thank you for your attention today.